Hi all, today I am going to discuss possible risk reduction measures. We cannot prevent natural earthquakes from occurring, but we can significantly mitigate their effects by identifying hazards, building safer structures, and providing education on earthquake safety. By preparing for natural earthquakes, we can also reduce the risk from human-induced earthquakes. Community preparedness. Community preparedness is vital for mitigating earthquake impact. The most effective way to save you even in a slightest shaking is drop, cover, and hold. First of all, we need planning. Before the buildings are constructed, the building plans have to be checked by the municipality according to the laid down by laws. Many existing lifeline buildings such as hospitals, schools and fire stations may not be built with earthquake safety measures. The earthquake safety needs to be upgraded by retrofitting technique. And second is public education. It's educating the public on causes and characteristics of an earthquake and preparedness measures. It can be created through sensitizations and training program for community architects, engineers, builders, teachers, and government functionaries, teachers, and students. And next is engineered structures. Buildings need to be designed and constructed as per the building bylaws to withstand ground shaking. Architectural and engineering inputs need to be put together to improve building design and construction practices. The soil type needs to be analyzed before construction, and building structures on soft soil should be avoided. And buildings on soft soil are more likely to get damaged even if the magnitude of the earthquake is not strong. And similar problem persists in the buildings constructed on the river banks which have alluvial soil. Okay, and next is resistant buildings. Consider the following parts of building. The first is foundation, and the next is body and the roof. First of all, the foundations. Structure on loose sediments, weak rocks is subjected to greater risk as compared to structures on hard rocks. And soil particles undergo settlement during earthquake, and foundation should be excavated to the same level. And the next is body. The walls should be properly designed for resisting lateral forces, and walls should be light in weight and made up of wood or lightweight as possible, and use reinforcements in the wall. And then last is the roof. Flat roofs gives better resistance as compared to sloping roofs. And projections beyond roof like chimneys should be avoided. And next is earthquake hazard mitigation. Unlike other disasters, the damage caused by earthquake are more devastating. And since it also destroys most of the transport and communication links, providing timely relief to the victims becomes difficult. It is not possible to prevent the occurrence of an earthquake. Hence, the next best option is to emphasize on disaster preparedness and mitigation rather than curative measures such as, first of all, establishing earthquake monitoring center for regular monitoring and fast dissemination of information among the people in the vulnerable areas. And use of GPS can be of great help in monitoring the movement of tectonic plates. And next is preparing a vulnerability map of the country and dissemination of vulnerability risk information among the people, and educating them about the ways and means minimizing the adverse impact of disasters. And the next is modifying the house types and building designs in the vulnerable areas, and discouraging construction of high-rise buildings large industrial establishments and big urban centers in such area, and finally making it mandatory to adopt earthquake resistant designs and use light materials in major construction activities in the vulnerable areas. And the next is mass movement. In many regions of the world, a temporary instability of superficial mass of soil and rock has always been an acute problem. This superficial mass may leave their original position abruptly or extremely slowly and start their downgrade movement or vertically downward sinking. And this movement of the ground may entail loss to property and life, especially when they happen to occur in or near the populated areas, along highways, railway lines, dams, and or under heavy structures. Such a movement of the superficial masses have been termed in common language as landslides or landslips, technically termed as mass movement. Okay, thank you.